Hello and welcome to Omni. This is your dashboard. Let's get started and just create your first cluster. The first thing you're going to want to do is download your install media. This is a wide range of providers here for options, everything from AWS, Azure, all the way to bare metal. In this case, I'm going to download the AMD 64 ISO, which is going to let me install it on an old desktop I have behind me. I'm also going to select the latest version of Talos here, 1.6.4. And optionally, you can put in extensions. These are other things your system can do, such as drivers, things like Tailscale, gVisor, lower level things that you can't do in a container. I'm just going to leave those off for now, and I don't have any kernel parameters, so I'm going to go ahead and download this ISO. While this is generating, it actually gives me all of the WireGuard connection information for my Omni instance, all of my endpoints and everything else, so that when I boot this ISO, it's going to automatically configure itself back into this environment. Now that I have it downloaded, I'm going to put it on a USB drive. I use a tool called Ventoy, which lets me have multiple ISOs on a single drive, but you can flash this to your USB drive however it is you like. Flash drive in hand, let's go boot that system. The system's booting behind me, so let's go back to the console and switch over to the Machines tab. This is where all of the machines that you boot off of your installation media will show up. And they're just going to come in as raw machines with some information about them, and then you configure them into clusters once you have them available. And here it is. The machine just booted, it connected back to the My instance, and now it says it's available and connected. So we can expand it, we can see a little more information. It's going to fill out more of this information as it actually scans the hosts. And there we go. You can see on the host, I see all of my memory available. I get labels for how many cores, CPU type, and even my install disk available here. So now let's go ahead and make the install happen and create a cluster. To do that, we're going to switch over to the clusters tab and create a cluster. You can give your cluster a name here at the top. You can set what version of Talos you want to install, as well as what version of Kubernetes you want to install as part of the process. I can select latest on both of those things. And then down here at the bottom, I'm going to select either a control plane or worker node for the node that I just booted. And in this case, it needs to be a control plane because I need to have a control plane available. Select which disk you want to install it on, and then create cluster. This will start automatically installing Talos on the node behind me. Right now, it's still booted off that USB drive, so it's not permanently installed to disk. If I wanted to, I can go ahead and remove the USB drive so that when the install happens, it's going to boot to this system and connect back in a cluster mode automatically. While that install's happening, we can actually go ahead and download our kubeconfig file and our Talos config. Both of these are for command line clients to be able to talk to either the node itself to configure things like patches if we're not using the Omni interface, or the kubeconfig to deploy workloads and whatnot into the Kubernetes cluster. I downloaded both those files, and the kubeconfig file is going to go in your /kube folder, and the Talos config is going to go in a .talos file in your home directory. We can see here that the cluster is running now. The machine rebooted, Talos installed, and all of the control plane components came up and are healthy.